everybody. It's Wednesday. It's kind of like a Friday, but it's Wednesday, April 8th, 2020. Let's get started on things we've got to do today. Hey, it's Wednesday, which means you've got an email. Previously, your email has been titled, Yo, but not this week. This week, you got an email titled Midweek Checklist. Yeah, because, I mean, we might as well call it what it is, because that's really what it is. It's a midweek checklist. That midweek checklist was put together by me yesterday on Tuesday. I started putting it together at about 3 p.m. So if you completed other work past 3 p.m., that list does not reflect that, okay? So when you get to it, there's some things in it that says not done. But you're like, hey, I did that yesterday. It's 7 o'clock at night. Yeah, okay. I wasn't checking things at 7 o'clock at night, so... you're going to have to forgive me on that one and be a little bit patient. I'll update those things as the day progresses. But if you find something on that list that you're like, hey, I absolutely did this, you should send me an email. We'll kind of talk about it. We'll figure out what it looks like. That list is in your email. It's titled Midweek Checklist. Go check it out. That list says on it, Figurative Language Doc. That's the first item. That is the document that you were supposed to begin where you defined metaphor and simile and gave me three examples of each. There's also a Khan Academy assignment on equal fractions. Several of you went and did the Khan Academy assignment from last week, but didn't attempt the Khan Academy assignment from this week. And there's even some of you who did the Khan Academy assignment from this week, but there's actually three graded portions of it, and you didn't do all three. So if it says not done, it means you haven't done it. If it says incomplete, it means you haven't finished it. Khan Academy, get on it. Dreamscape, simile, and metaphor. Hey, you know what? Dreamscape, I was playing it yesterday. I had a really good time. I destroyed Chandler's base. It was like the most fun thing ever. I'm going to do it again later on. If you're not down with that game, if you're like, hey, I don't understand, I don't want to play this game, you still have to do the assignments. But you can skip the entire game part and just do the assignments. To do that, on the bottom left corner, there's an hourglass, and it says question. If you really don't want to play the game, when you get logged in, just click on the questions, answer the questions. I will start letting you know when I put a Dreamscape assignment up how many questions it is, so you know how many to get through. This one is 20 for this assignment. There's 10 questions on metaphors, 10 questions on similes, total of 20 questions for you to answer. Once it starts asking you questions that aren't about similes and metaphors, you can assume you're done. If you don't want to play Dreamscape, you don't have to, but you do have to answer those questions, all right? Dreamscape. A lot of us yesterday were tasked to do the assignment. Some of us needed to start an entire new... You need to get yourself logged in, figure out how to do it. You need to get that done, all right, folks? Dreamscape. It's how we're going to deliver a lot of our figurative language assignments. Get it working on it. All right, after Dreamscape, word of the day. Word of the day. There's a new word today. It's one of the only things I'm going to ask you to do that's new today. Word of the day. Division story problems, that was given out on Tuesday. I would like it to be sent in to me today. There's actually a math lesson that you'll watch today, which is about that assignment, how to calculate it, what are some of the ways to do it, and what are the answers. So if you haven't sent it to me yet, you should do it. Now make sure that you take a picture and email that right on off to me, please. That is the one about division story problems. Article a day. You should have had about four Native American articles done. Four of them. If you don't have four done, I sent you an email and said, hey, you did two out of four. You did three out of four. You did one out of four. You did none out of four. Let's get on those today. Article of the day, please, about Native American facts. And then there's those two Google Forms. It's not due till the end of the day today on Wednesday, so you get some time. Make sure those get in there. That is the first thing that I want you to tackle today, is that email. You should grab an adult so that they can check in with you. But even if you don't, those items need to get done. All right, folks? Not a lot of new stuff today. Just making sure that that old stuff is all caught up. That's what the midweek checklist is for. Okay. You've got your typical non-negotiable tasks have to get done today. Those get done every single day. They're even available for you to do on the weekend if you want to. Yeah. Non-negotiable tasks look like your Lexia for 20 minutes, stamina reading, find a book, find a place, and read. Extramath.com, make sure you're getting those facts in there. Those multiplication and division facts are super important to make sure that you have those mastered. Reworked article a day, you're going to do a new one today. If you've done four up to today, that means to be updated at the end of the day, you're going to have done five. And then you're going to email me at the end of the day. Tasks specific to Wednesday. Hey, if we were in school and it was Wednesday, we'd go to music class. But we're not in school. But you're still going to go to music class. So go check out the music's Google Classroom, please. There is also a math number corner for you to do. I would like you to watch the video. It's very short, and it updates today. It also tasks you to update tomorrow, and the day after that, 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 all the way up until Monday of next week. So make sure you get that form out. Make sure you've got your number calendar, number corner, April calendar on fractions. Either print it off or recreate it in front of you, and you're updating it. You're not just sitting there and watching the video. I'm watching a video. No, you actually have to do something with it, folks. Make sure that gets filled out. Don't procrastinate and fall behind. Say, oh, it's not due till the end of the month. I'll do it later on. Oh, that's going to sneak up on you. And it's not going to pan out well. You've also got the story problems. We already talked about that one. Make sure that you watch it. That is on the assignment that was posted yesterday. It looks like this one. And it's due Wednesday, today. You folks have, you got tomorrow to do stuff, you got today to do stuff, you got Friday to do stuff, you've got some stuff to do. If you sign in on Monday and you're like, I don't want to do any of this stuff, it's not due till Wednesday, I don't know why you're procrastinating. It's not a wise decision, okay? Those things are going to catch up on you quickly. In interest of making sure that you understand that staying on top of your work is important, your word of the day is procrastinate. Yeah, don't procrastinate. Make sure that you're getting those things done on a regular basis. It is so much easier to do 15, 20 minutes of work every day than it is to do 3 hours of work in one day. I know, I still do it as an adult all the time. All right, folks, I haven't learned my lesson. Why don't you learn my lesson for me? Why don't you do better than me? Don't procrastinate. Get your stuff done. Hey, there's no school tomorrow. There's no new tasks. There's a new test the day after that, or there's no new tasks for the day after that. Y'all got a very long weekend. Enjoy it. Stay home. Wash your hands. Be safe. See you on Monday.